Hello, and this is the 18th stage of the Tour de France. After a day where we saw Nibali show sign of weakness, it is actually make us believe that we can get Contador back in the podium place. But still, the podium place is one thing and the yellow jersey is another thing. Probably right now we have like a 50% chance to actually get in the podium place and only 20% chance to get in a yellow jersey, because the strength Nibali is showing is still enough. Thibaut Pinot, the great hope from France, are still number 2, and Alejandro Valverde number 3. And even Chris Froome was winning the last stage, he's still behind, almost 2 minutes behind Contador, and 4 minutes behind Alejandro Valverde. We have to see what is happening from the few stages. Which is a stage fairly long and have a lot of things to consider. There's a sprint jersey, there's a mountain jersey, and maybe we should try to get Micah on attack now, because he was in the last stage he was not moving, he was actually helping. This stage is hard because there's a HC climb on the last 15 kilometers that can make a difference, and with a long descent, and then the just come a little hilly before the finish with a long straight on 10 kilometers, and it should be hard to actually hold a breakaway if you have a breakaway with a rider like Contador or something. But we have to see. Alberto Contador is a favorite for this stage, Quintana and Froome also. Contador's goal is to win the stage. He's in good shape, you see. And there's one thing we can do here. It put the pressure on from start to finish, but it's gonna cost in the end if we are doing that. But we try out to see what's is going on from the start, and we try to put Micah on a breakaway. Micah can actually take the mountain jersey on this stage because there's like 25, exactly 40 points on this stage.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. The stage on offer today should please the climbers. With a Col du Glandon on the Lacet de Montvernier climbs in the last 60 kilometers, everything is set up to enable them to go on the offensive.
Okay, we'll relay.
The riders will be straight into the thick of it with a Col Bayard climb. 6.3 kilometers at an average of 7%.
Today we have no choice. This is a crucial stage for the overall standings, and we're going to have to attack if we want to make up our arrears. So, good luck, lads, and do your best.
Okay, I'll protect him. So I stick to the wheels in front.
There's plenty of damage at the back of the peloton. It will be a long day in the saddle for those who fall behind. That's good enough, lads. There's no way we can lose the green jersey today. It's good.
Counter-attack inside the peloton.
Quintana has been left behind.
Okay, we'll relay.
it's not looking good for those favorites. Already the con making a good acceleration on this.
You're 1 minute 30 ahead of the peloton. It's looking good. A teammate is beginning to lose touch. Here's the positions over the last climb. You were first over the top of the climb. That's good.
Whether on mountain stages or on hills, he's to be taken seriously as he climbs well.
I'll relay. I'll take it easy on the relay.
His best chance of victory is to try a breaking jersey. First Canadian rider to win a Grand Tour, the Tour of Italy, Rade Hesjal is an attacking climber.
Yeah, we saw that in the Giro this year.
Robert Gesink is a very good puncher who's relatively at ease in the mountains. Used to top 10 placings in the Ardennes Classics and the Tour of Spain, he lacks a prestigious victory to enter the elite puncher category. He does well on short climbs, but he can't really rely on his sprint qualities to hope for a win.
You're coming up to the intermediate sprint. Keep your eyes open. The best sprinter in the group. Take his wheel if you want to score some points.
We actually don't care about the points.
He's a good climber puncher over any kind of obstacle. He's a pure climber, able to follow the very best when he's in shape.
Here's the winner of the intermediate sprint. Up the pace, guys, to prepare for the intermediate sprint.
It's not one point to get, so it doesn't matter about second.
I'll relay. I'll take it easy on the relay. Okay, I'll protect him. Okay, I'll protect him. So I regain my carte blanche.
Thank you. one point.
I'll relay. I'll take it easy on the relay.
You are 2 kilometers from the summit. Watch your opponents. You seem to be the best climber in the group. You should be able to move to the front.
Should not use too much energy. It would be stupid.
He launched the mountain sprint.
It's only 1 point. No need to use too much energy for that.
Here's the positions over the last climb.
I'll relay. I'll take it easy on the relay. Okay, we'll gently relay. Okay, I'll protect him. Okay, we'll gently relay.
The riders will climb 3 third category climbs in succession. The Côte de la Mure, the Col de Malisol, and the Col de la Motte. At the top of each, there will be 2 points and 1 point to be won for the polka dot jersey.
You should probably... Oh, wait a minute. Wait for the next uphill section.
You are 2 kilometers from the summit. Watch your opponents. You should perhaps be waiting for the group behind. It will be easier if there are several of you. You're 2 kilometers from the summit. Go on, another push! You seem to be the best climber in the group. You should be able to move to the front.
Get the 2 points.
Here's the positions over the last climb. You were first over the top of the climb. That's good.
And now, the second part.
The leaders are on the Col de Malisol.
He's the best placed in the overall standings amongst those at the head of the race.
Now the toughest climb. This first part. See myself doing a little work with the team on this stage, this part.
Okay, we'll gently relay. Okay, I'll protect him. Okay, we'll gently relay.
Riding hard behind. This isn't the moment to relax. His teammates are taking things in hand behind the breakaway.
I'll relay. Try and hinder relays.
The escapees are beginning the climb of the Col de la Motte. 3 kilometers at an average of 8.4%.
Thank you.
2 kilometers from the summit. Watch your opponents. You're 2 kilometers from the summit. Go on, another push. You seem to be the best climber in the group. You should be able to move to the front.
There we go.
Here's the positions over the last climb.
And now we need to get back to Contador.
You were first over the top of the climb. That's good.
The riders must stay focused on the descent. There are many tricky bends to be negotiated.
The fuck?
The breakaway is increasing its lead over the yellow jersey, but there's no worry as it contains no big guns for the overall standings.
Okay, we'll relay.
What is going on here?
Is riding hard. Stay well placed. He asked his teammates to maintain the tempo. He must feel on form.
There's a crash.
Today.
Crash in the peloton.
He's gone down. His teammates will no doubt wait for him.
It should be our way to get this tempo up.
It doesn't seem to be a good day for him. He's being distanced.
Okay, we'll relay hard. Okay, I'm coming to protect you. I'll try and hinder relays.
Sagan has crashed.
The gap
good.
With the yellow jersey is melting away. The escapees will have difficulties going all the way.
Thibaut Pinot and the secondary group because he crashed before.
Understood.
Estonia has lost a lot of riders right now. It looked like this.
The front runners are at the feed zone. Tension should gradually build as they get closer to the Col de Glandon.
I'll relay. Okay, I'm coming to protect you.
Like it.
Okay, we'll gently relay.
Pinot is still 1:30 behind, and Leon Vista has dropped from the peloton. It's good, it's 2 Aston Martin riders.
Relay.
Finish at a stroll.
Okay, I'll take it easy to the finish.
Finish at a stroll.
Okay, I'll take it easy to the finish. Understood. Understood.
I feel pretty good. I don't have sore legs in the car.
And now we're doing a fast forward until the first climb. You see there. Right about